You know, after my male's funeral, the doors of every major opera house in the world slammed open to me. So I was now the Regalute coach. But in the night, my male was also leaving. I was traveling all over the world singing with conductors. Notice I did not say maestro. Mandel warned me about conductors. The era, he would say. The vocal life of soprano has four stages. Bel canto, can belto, can belto, can canto. Conductors will get you to stage four quicker than you can say, I was coloratura, then it was spinto. Now I'm spento. And he was right, you know? These conductors had me singing everything. I mean, every artist has her speciality, her métier, as we say in opera, her fach. And my fach was bel canto. But they had me singing everything. Verdi, Wagner, Strauss, Puccini, I was completely fucked up. They even wanted me to sing early music. Early music, please, I don't even get up until one. And suddenly opera was being ruled by all these trendy young stage directors. Kinder with concept. They would walk into the rehearsal, they would jog into the rehearsal, wearing their steps pants. A libretto in one hand, a hatchet in the other, walking the Evian water, way friendly. And they would always make me get down on the floor and do some warm-up where I'm looking like a cockroach that's just been sprayed with insecticide. Oh, I know I sound very old-fashioned, but remember, it was I who first sang the underwater Tosca at the Bass of Caracalla. Who has invented the term dramatic soprano. I have taken chances in my day, so you please forgive me if I do not wish to come to rehearsal and have some pipsqueak of a director tell me I have to warm up by standing on my hair. Renata Tabaldi never stood on her hair. And she could have. That's for the younger generation. Let Renee stand on her hair. Let Miss Netrebko stand it. Oh, she did. My generation, we stood on our arm. Eh? Of course, that was long before the three tenors. You know, I think it's just so wonderful to be living in an age entirely unencumbered by standards. There are some singers I do like, and a few of them is still living. But one of the ones who isn't was Madame Jenny Correll, who taught me this next song. Shortly after I came to New York, I went to a recital at Alice Belly Hall of Jenny Correll. She was accompanied at that time by a little baby pianist named James Levine. He was pretty good. And Jenny was amazing. Immediately I went backstage and I begged her to teach me. She was a French-Russian distraction, so it was perfect. We could scream at each other in Russian. And she had such a temper that fun. You know, she was all 5 feet tall, but she packed quite a lot of. In fact, I still have, for a souvenir in my freezer, the autographed steak she gave me. With a black eye, I came to learning this song. Her next recital was at Town Hall. And it turned out to be her last. And the final encore in that recital was this next song. I have heard many, many singers sing this song since, everyone from Jesse Norman to Velocity Clip. Velocity Bob. But it is Jenny. Or as those of us close to her were permitted to call her, Madame Tourelle. Who is still in my ears. This song is by Franz Liszt. It is called Au Quand Je Dors, set to a text by Victor Hugo. When I am sleeping, come near my head, and appeal to me as Laura here to get dry. And when your breath touches me lightly, my mouth will reach for it and find you. If on my sad brow a dark mood passes for too long, I will see your glance, and suddenly I will feel myself rise up. Then the flame of love, purified by God himself, will place on my lips a kiss. And angel will become lover. Come. Come.
Oh, come.
Appear to me. As Laura appeared.
Oh, Yeah.